Here's a cool way to quickly remember the shapes of graphs that you're going to come across in the higher order mathematics. So even if you're in second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth grade, this will be very helpful. So let's look at it. Linear, the word linear has in it line, okay? So let's go here and, okay, L, the graph of a linear function looks like that, a line. So a linear function is something of the form y equals, let's say, 2x minus 3. Okay, linear. Okay, the power of the x variable is 1. We don't write the 1. Look at hyperbola. Now, this is a complex equation here, a little different. But look at the h here. All right, just look at the, like an H, okay? So, an hyperbola looks something like this when you graph it, okay? Quadratic, look at the U in quadratic. So, a quadratic function is usually an upside down or reverse, looks like a U shape, a parabola, okay? So this is what a quadratic function looks like. In quadratic functions, if we take this here, quadratic function would be something of the form y is equal to 2x squared minus 3, okay? Just making it squared. Absolute value, okay? Absolute value, that V there. The absolute value is basically saying, what's the distance from 0? What's the distance from 0? Okay, so that's an absolute value. It has this V shape. Because if I'm at negative 1 and I'm at 1, the absolute value in both cases is 1. Both are 1 units away from 0. And then we have a trigonometric function, a sine function, and you have the n, right? An n. And the graph of a sine function looks like that. So some quick ways to remember what a linear, L, line, hyperbola, womp, H, quadratic, U, the U, quadratic, absolute value, V shape, and sine doing a little wave dance. This is your sine function. And so when you see graphs, this should trigger for you what these functions look like. So this is y equals the sine of x. Okay. All right. Remember, practice makes the genius. Practice makes better.